I think the cutting edge of medicine is really not always high tech. It's being more focused on prevention and being proactive, understanding your genetics. We're at a $1,000 genome today, we'll be at $100 or even a free genome in the next decade. We know that sitting is the new smoking. We now have wearables that we can stick in our clothes and our cars and our phones that are gonna help give us insights into our behaviors. We're in the era of integrating exponential technologies together. I have in my pocket a version of the first medical tricorder, part of a clinical trial from a company called Scanadu that started at Singularity University. So as a consumer, you can track your vital signs very readily. That can help you do a better job of understanding health, wellness, early disease detection and triage. Technologies like having an AI doctor blended with sensors like this one has in your pocket as a consumer will help you be more proactive, realizing that the best drug is, you know, walking, doing 30 minutes of exercise a day, being reasonable about your diet. And when we can use some of these tools as levers, understanding that behavior change is hard. If you can look in the mirror in the morning and see future you, and if your future you is 100 pounds heavier, that might change your lever on behavior change. We can use, I think, Myers-Briggs type things of behavior change to understand your carrot and your stick, because just like precision and personalized medicine, not everyone needs the same drug or the same app or the same interface. We can start to use AI and feedback loops integrated into your workday, integrated into your wearables, into your apps to be more proactive. And if you think about how the world shifted, we've only had smartphones for 7 years. The desktop of 2000 fits on your smartphone, and as of now, it fits on my smartwatch, which can kind of give you a bit of a Google Now, not just leave work for early because of traffic, but you need to check in the gym and get a few extra calories today if you're gonna stay on track to a certain goal or to help manage diabetes or emphysema or heart disease. And we're seeing a whole new realm of sort of digital diagnostics. In my pocket, I have an attachment as an otoscope that can go on your phone. I have 3D printed parts. Here's Mini-Me. You know, so we have new tools that you can use at home, whether it's 3D printing a cast if you've had a fracture. And here's an example from 3D systems. Scan your fracture, make one that fits you. All these things are enabling cheaper, faster, more effective healthcare. It could democratize it around the planet. You can have, you know, telemedicine, talking to your doctor or nurse on Skype, anywhere on the planet, which has increasingly broadband accessibility. You can have diagnostics, labs on a chip. It's not just our quantified self data, it's the ability to do this on your smartphone or to communicate that to a pathologist here in New York from rural Africa. All those things are shifting the power curve to the empowered, engaged consumer and patient who can be a data donor, can be connected to their own data to gain insights early, can have visits with their clinician in more seamless, less expensive, and less time-consuming ways. So we're at an interesting era now, where, whether it's a tricorder, or knowing your own genomics, or having embedded sensors, kind of like your own personal check engine light, can really shift healthcare diagnostics and therapy in smart ways. So I think the most important thing anyone can do is start owning their own health, using tools and apps to quit smoking, get on a diet, tweet out their weight from your scale. All those things can come together in powerful ways to be more proactive and preventative as opposed to waiting for disease to happen. So be the COO of your own health. Don't wait for your doctor to tell you what you need to do when you're in the ER or worse.